You are able to see the screen.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sorry, we will start our this one. So last class, if you see, right? So we have discussed, I think, you know, the arches, and finally we went to these plates. Okay, so anyway, we will come back to arches, you know, after some point of time when we go towards shells to understand that snap through buckling and others. Okay, so now anyway, so the plate theory, you know, we have started in our last class, you know. So this was our plate theory, say. Okay, so what we try to do is, you know, the Kirchhoff plate theory. So it is same as your strength of material theory, whatever you have studied in your undergraduation, but only thing you followed, right? You are now extending it to two dimensional, that is for the plates. So as already I told you, right? So when you know, when you have done this, plane sections are rigid and all kinds of things, so no point in talking in terms of stresses. So we define you know, these quantities which we are calling as, you know, this stress resultants. Okay, so only problem now here what we have in our for plate is, you know, many are stress resultants are there. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 stress resultants are there. Okay, so these are, like, you know, we have said, right, in plane normal, then you know, the in plane shear, then QX, QY, say. So they are also shear only, but the transverse, you know, some different notation is used also. Okay, then we have bending moments, then we have the twisting moments also. So one most important thing is all the units, when it comes to plates, all the stress resultants, okay, like bending moment, shear force, for beams, you know, they will be in proper units, like, you know, newtons, newton meter, like that. But in plate theory, because you are averaging only with respect to z direction, say, so they all units will be, you know, per unit length, like, you know, a newton per meter or something like that. Okay, so now equations of equilibrium. So last class we have denoted, like, how to derive our equations of equilibrium, say. It is straightforward, it is same as you know, what you would derived, is it, in our this theory itself. Okay, like, say you write, you take a body, you know, you all the forces, say, you write, and then you know, you solve sigma fx, sigma fy, kind of as this thing, and then finally, you know, you come up with this equilibrium equations. Okay, so this we wrote for shear. Okay, now this also we wrote for you know, the bending moment and twisting moments. Now the what we told was, this is the problem when it comes to the in-plane shear and in-plane axial forces, say, because the plate is bent, right, in a z direction, so you have to consider you know, all those changes. Okay, so this is what we said. So dou w by dou x is the rotation angle here, then dou w by dou y this side, say. Okay, so now you know, so you have to encounter, see, like, for example, nx, so this angle is dou w by dou x, so this also you have to expand in terms of Taylor series, even the angle also. Okay, so this angle also, or the slope actual, so this also expand in terms of Taylor series. So you will get all these components, I think I have drawn, but one thing is remaining. Okay, that is you know, nyx, and then, you know, nxy. So we have you know, nyx, then we have, you see, this nxy. Okay, so this angle also have to be taken care, so this angle. Okay, so this angle here, it is you know, dou w by, you see, dou y. Okay, this is dou w by dou y this side, so now how much it will be this angle also. Okay, so this also we have to expand in terms of Taylor series, so this angle you know, so we can write this as, you see, dou w by dou y. So dou w by dou y is here. Okay, so now here, so this also you have to expand in terms of Taylor series. So dou by dou x, so you followed it. So dou w by dou y. So this is this angle here. Now similarly, say, so here also you have to find out this angle. So here this angle is dou w by dou x here. So now this is a dy. So here also you have, you know, so dou w by, you see, dou x. So this also expand in terms of Taylor series. So dou by dou y. So dou w by dou x, okay, and of course multiplied by dy will be there. So this is how you expand all these quantities, you know, in a nice, you see, the fashion itself. I think we have drawn. So now this also will try here. So now we have taken nxy, nxny. So now this quantity will be, you know, so nyx, okay, plus dou nyx by, you say, dou y into dy here. And then here also you have this, you know, nxy, this side also. Okay, so I'm writing here. So this also you have to expand. So nxy, say, plus dou nxy by dou x into dx. Okay, so this is how. So only thing here is because a number of things are so many are there, say, so you know, many things becomes a little complex, but otherwise, you know, it is straightforward as what you have done in your beam theory itself. Okay, both are same. Only thing here it is, you know, two-dimensional things are coming into picture. Okay, so now let us write our equations of equilibrium. Okay, so now to write equations of equilibrium, so this is for in-plane shear, in-plane normal. So then you have a transverse shear, then you have a bending moment and twisting moments. Okay, so now you know, let us write our equations of equilibrium. Okay, so now resolve. Okay, so now let us write equations of equilibrium. So now you resolve, you know, in x direction. So sigma, you see, fx is equal to 0. Okay, so now when you try to do this one, say, so now here what happens is, and assume that the things are small actual. Okay, so we assume that these angles are, you know, small. So angles of rotation. Okay, so two rotations are there. So dou w by dou x and dou w by, you know, dou y. Okay, so they are, if you assume them as small, say, okay, so as all of, you know, so when theta is small, cos theta becomes 1 and sine theta becomes the same as theta itself. Okay, so now you take six, and here one more important thing here is, so these units, as already I told you, nx, ny, qx, qy, all their units are per unit length. Okay, but now we are writing force equilibrium, say, so now we have to multiply by, you know, the length of the member, you know, to get this force itself. So now if you write equation in x direction, so anyway qx, qy doesn't have any component in x, and of course moments doesn't come into picture. So now in x direction, say, so now if you try to write this expression, so you have nx, you know, cos theta. So nx into, you followed, right? Dou w by dou x you have, but as already I told you, when dou w by dou x is very small, say, so cos theta becomes 1 itself. So you can write as you followed, right? Nx into dy itself. So making all those things, so if you try to write, you know, so this becomes minus, you know, nx, and of course dy, because, you know, to convert into a force. And on this side, say, so you have nx plus dou nx, okay, by dou x into dx into dy. So here also you have cos theta, because theta is small, say, okay, so cos theta can be taken it as 1 itself. Now in x directions, apart from these two forces, nx, you know, this force itself, you are also having, you know, these terms also, nyx, you know, so these also terms are also acting here. So these terms also, if you include, say, so minus, you know, nyx into, you know, dx plus, you know, nyx plus dou nyx by, you say, dou y into dy, say, multiplied by dx. So this is equal to 0. So now you cancel some of the things and write nicely. So you can write this as, you know, dou nx, say, by, you know, dou x plus dou nyx, okay, by dou y, so is equal to 0. So this is the one equation, you see, you get, assuming, you know, sigma fx is equal to 0. Okay, now in a similar fashion, say, you write the forces in y direction also. Okay, so when you try to write the forces in y direction also, so automatically q, bending moment, doesn't come into picture. So the only thing is, you see, the ny and n, you know, xy, these terms comes into picture, and assuming cos theta 1 and sin theta is 0, so you can write the expressions, you know, easily. So this turns out to be dou nxy, say, okay, by dou x plus dou ny by dou y is equal to 0. So you will get, you know, a nice, you know, the equations like this. So this turns out to be for sigma fy is equal to 0. So now we have to do this sigma, you know, fz is equal to 0. So this is where the big problem comes actually. Okay, so you have to include, you know, so many terms. So when you said the z direction, say, so what happens is, you know, So this nx, ny, they also will have components in xz direction. So nx, y, sine theta, those terms will be there. Plus you also have in the directions, so this is shear forces, transverse shear forces also have to taken into consideration. Anyway, movements doesn't come into picture itself. So now let us write that all the components here, say, okay. So you can write this big expression comes. So one can write this expression as, you know. So minus nx, you have dy. So now here what happens? So in z direction, say, what is the component of nx here? So if this angle is theta, say, okay. So you have nx times sine theta. But here the problem is, you know, when theta is very small, say, so sine theta will be same as, you know, theta itself. So nx into dou w by dou x also will come into picture, okay. So you resolve, say, so nx into dy, so you have, so dou w by dou x also. So this problem comes. Now you have nx term, this side also, the Taylor series, you know, so dou nx by, you know, dou x into dx. But here the angle also we have expanded in terms of Taylor series. So you have that term also comes into picture. So dou w by dou x plus dou square w, say, by dou x square into, say, dx. So this term also comes into picture because sine theta is same as theta itself. So this is similarly, so you write all other terms, ny term also. So dou w by dou y plus, ny plus dou ny, okay, by dou y into dy multiplied by dx. So this angle also comes here. So dou w by dou y plus dou square w by dou y square into dy, okay. So these are the components. And now similarly, these terms, shear forces, say, so qx into dy plus so qx plus dou qx by dou x into dx into dy, and now qy term also, so qy into dx plus qy plus dou qy by dou y into dy into dx. Okay, so these are the shear forces. So now nx we have written in plane, this axial components, and transverse shear we have written. We also have to write this in plane shear also. Okay, so that is nxy. So this also you write these components. So dy, so dou w by dou y, okay, plus nxy, say, plus dou nxy by dou x into dx multiplied by dy, and you have the Taylor series letter. So dou w by dou y plus dou square w by dou x dou y into dx. So now similarly n y x term also comes into dx into dou w by dou x plus n y x plus dou n y x by dou y into dy multiplied by dx. So dou w by dou x plus dou square w by dou x dou y into dy. And of course, if there is any load is acting on the plate, say, okay, the transverse load, so then it will be dx into dy is equal to 0. Okay, so this is how, so this p is nothing but, you see, the load in vertical direction. If there is any for the plate. Okay, same like our IRR Bernoulli beam theory, you know, the load we have, right, transverse load. So if you write, you see, so you get this expression. So now here, you know, if you neglect all the higher order terms, you say, so you are having two derivatives, you know. So you neglecting, you know, the higher order terms, and then you have to simplify. So if you neglect, you know, two derivatives and other things, so finally the equation, we can write the whole thing in a nice fashion. So dou nx by dou x plus dou n y x dou y. So we have, you know, dou w by dou x plus dou n x, so y by dou x plus dou n y by dou y into dou w by dou y, okay. So plus we have nx dou square w by dou x square plus nxy dou square w by dou x dou y plus nyx by dou x dou y plus ny dou y square plus dou qx by dou x plus dou qy by dou y plus p is equal to 0. Okay, so you get some big expressions comes into here. But now one thing you can simplify, what is the value of these two terms? No. See, what are these two? See, these two are same as, you know, our sigma fx is equal to 0 and sigma fy is equal to 0. So we have already got two equations. So dou nx by dou x plus dou nyx by dou y, this is also 0. This is also equal to 0. Okay, so now making use of that one. So finally, what happens is, you know, so making use of that condition is there. Okay. Yeah. So what happens here is, you know, so these two will go to 0 itself. So if we can write this expression as, you know, like this. So dou q, you know, x by dou x plus dou q y, say, by dou y plus, you know, nx. So dou square w by dou x square plus ny. Dou square w by, you know, dou y square plus 2 times nx1. Dou square w by dou x dou y. Okay, plus p is equal to 0. Okay, so this is our third equation, which is, you know, sigma fz is equal to 0 itself. Okay, so now if you neglect one dimension, say all of them will collapse to your Euler-Bernoulli, you know, the equation itself. Okay, so only thing is because of two dimensions, you know, so you have many terms, you know, coming into picture here. That's the only difference. So now this is one thing. So now you take moment equilibrium also. Okay, so if you take moment equilibrium, you know, about x-axis is equal to 0, so you can easily calculate this. This nx, ny, they all will not come into picture because they are all in plane forces, say. So in your moment equilibrium, only thing what happens is, so if you try to try the moment equilibrium, so these things will not come into our picture because they are all in plane forces. Okay, so for moment equilibrium, say, so about the x-axis, if you try to take, so bending moments will be there, then you also will have moments from this transverse shearing forces. So these two only will contribute to our moment equilibrium equations. Okay, so now this also you can write. So some big you know, this expressions, you know, also if you try to write, so after neglecting and all those higher order terms and other things, so dou my by, you know, sorry, dou y minus dou mxy by using dou x plus qy is equal to 0, and similarly say my is equal to 0. Okay, so this also gives rise to dou mx by dou x plus dou myx, okay, by dou y and minus qx is equal to 0. So these are our moment equilibrium equations itself. Okay, so now here, you know, so now how many equations are there, right? So we are having three force equilibrium are there, and then two moment equilibrium are there. So now we can combine actually all of them into one equation, you know, kind of a thing. So now in this equation, say, so these equations relate, you know, qx, qy to bending moments. So these relations can be substituted in this expression. So we have shear force terms are there. So you can substitute actually this moment equilibrium. So this moment equilibrium equations is here, okay. So you substitute in this equation, so we can write a nice, you know, the expression itself. You can eliminate the shear forces directly, write in terms of bending moment and your in plane shear itself. So this becomes, you know, dou square mx by, you know, dou x square plus 2 times, say, dou square, you know, myxy by dou x times dou y plus we have, you know, dou square my by dou x square, so dou y square, okay, plus nx, dou square w by dou x square, plus ny, w by dou y square, plus 2 times nxy, so dou square w by, you know, dou x dou y plus p is equal to 0. So this is our basic, you know, the equation of motion, say, for plates, okay. So now suppose if the plate is subjected to only transverse load, say, so then, you know, so these terms, you know, will be 0. So you have only, you followed it, the bending moments will be there, and you have this load which is coming into picture is equal to zero itself. And if you neglect, so nx, ny, these are all axial forces, okay, the in-plane forces, axial, the in-plane axial and in-plane, the shear. Now you followed. So these are all, so suppose you can, if you neglect, say, if you neglect these in-plane, these in-plane forces and then, mx, y, my, say, automatically this everything collapses to a beam equation. Okay, one can show also. They followed that Euler-Bernoulli, the beam equation itself. Because it has come from Euler-Bernoulli, that same assumption. So if you neglect this in-plane axial shear and this one, everything collapses to you once again, you follow, right? This itself. See, like for example, if you neglect one dimension, so what happens, you see? So if you neglect one dimension, so this automatically you have these terms if you look closely, say. So now if you neglect one dimension, so this term will go away. So now you all know, right, what's a relationship between, you see, shear force and bending moment, right? The derivative of bending moment is same as, the shear force kind of a thing. So same, whatever you studied in Euler-Bernoulli, say. So same, you followed, right? The equations comes into the picture also. So this theory, as already I told you, this is what we call as, the Kirchhoff plate theory. Okay, so this is a plate theory, they say. Okay, so now here, we have written, we have derived the free body diagram, we have drawn, we have found out, what are the forces which are acting on our plate, then we have written, the equations of equilibrium also. So now we will also write this strain displacement relations also, okay. To write these equations, directly in terms of displacements, we require this strain displacement relations. Now you follow. So now here also, we will use the same whatever, Euler-Bernoulli beam theory itself we will use. So here we will, write like this, the strain displacement relations, okay. So let us denote, so the notation you please, so U, V, W. So these are the three components of displacements. Okay, so U and V are horizontal, and W is followed, right, in Z direction. That is, that is how we assume here. So let's assume that these are the three displacements at centroidal plane. Okay, so these are at the centroidal plane. Okay, so now we have to assume, so now and we denote, this U bar, V bar, sorry. So we denote U bar, V bar, W bar, say. So these are the displacements at any point in the plane cross sections. Then they have displacements in the plane cross sections. Okay. Now, see, like in our strength of material theory, say. So how do you solve this one? So if you're having one dimensional, say for beam theory, okay, so these are our plane cross sections. So before, you apply the load. So now in our Euler-Bernoulli beam theory, what we say is, the plane cross sections remain plane, that is one assumption. Apart from that, so the most important assumption is in these plane cross sections, say, they lie always, perpendicular to your neutral axis, okay. So these are also one main assumption. Try to do in our plane cross sections. So now here, suppose if I know the deflection, say like, so in the present case, so what we are doing is, so U, V, W are nothing but, the displacement about, the centroidal axis. So now if I want to find out displacements at any point in the plane cross sections, say like for example here, so how much is U, okay? So that is a displacement actual in the plane cross section. What suppose, let us say it is lying at a distance of z from your centroidal axis. We can write this as r cross theta. So z cross theta itself. So now in our beam theory, that in Euler-Bernoulli beam theory, so because plane sections remain plane. So how, what will be this angle? So any of you know? So like for example, this is our plane cross section. Okay. So these at an angle. So if I take as a, if I draw a tangent here, say. Okay. So this is our, this 90 degree angle or whatever we have here. So now this angle, okay, so this theta, So suppose if this is du, okay, and this is you know some dz kind of a thing you have, say. So now because of this cross sections, you know, you follow. So you can write this theta as, you know, so du by dz we can write, or you can also write, you know, in terms of this also. So you draw a tangent here, okay. So you try to, you know, this equation. Say. So now this angle also will be, you see, so this is dw, okay, and this is dx. So now this, because of plane cross sections remain always perpendicular to your, you know, the centroidal axis, say, okay. So this theta will be same. So this also can be written as, you see, dw by dx also. That is how, you know, we write it in our, you know, this, what we call this, you know, the this, you know, Euler-Bernoulli beam theory. So what happens is, you know, u becomes z into theta. So we write as z into, you know, dw by dx. So when you come to the strains, say, okay, so the strain, you know, so your epsilon xx, okay, so this becomes, you know, dou u by dou x kind of a thing. So this becomes z into, you know, d square w by dx square, and your shear strain. Okay, suppose if you take as epsilon xz, say, so this becomes, you know, so dou u by, you remember, so dou u by, you see, dou z, and then, you know, plus you have dou w by dou x kind of a thing. So now, you know, so this automatically, because, you know, so your dou u by dou z, this, you know, sign change will be there. So we neglect this shear terms in our, you know, Euler-Bernoulli beam theory. So finally, we write this epsilon xx as like this. And then we write, you remember, sigma xx is, you know, e into epsilon xx. So we write this as, you know, ez into, you see, d square w by dx square. So this is our strain. So now to derive our Euler-Bernoulli beam theory, say, so we calculate movement. So movement is nothing but a stress resultant, you remember. So we write as sigma xx into dA, okay. So if you substitute here, you know, so E comes, sorry, sigma xx into z into dA, okay. This is a movement here. So E comes out, so z square d square w by dx square into dA comes here. So this expression can be written as, you know, so this expression, you know, you generally we can write this as E into, so d square w by dx square also can be pulled outside. So z square into dA. What is z square into dA? You know, for a beam. So what is z square into dA?
I.
It's a moment of inertia. Okay. So EI d square w by dx square. We write. What is d square w by dx square? The second derivative. In beam theory, so what is the second derivative? D square y by dx square. So you write as e into y by, you see, r. So that is how, you see, your m by r is equal to, you know, m by I is equal to e by r. So this is how we have derived, actually, in our Euler-Bernoulli, you know, the beam theory. Suppose if you take axial forces in Euler-Bernoulli beam theory, the axial force is given by sigma xx into, you know, this dA. So then if you substitute, say, okay, so sigma xx is, we have already written, right, ez into d square w by dx square, so e into d square w by dx square, integral z into dA, we write. Since there is no axial forces which are acting in an Euler-Bernoulli, you know, the beam theory, say, so this integral z dA has to be zero, okay. What is this meaning of this expression? Because there is no axial force. So in Euler-Bernoulli beam theory, what is that you try to say? What is that you say? When z dA is equal to 0, so what does it tells you? Physically. What does it tells you? When z into dA is 0, so the first moment is 0, so generally for any cross section shape. What do you call that one? Where it will be 0? See, in your undergraduate, right, in strength of materials, what is that you try to do? You remember, there are, you know, the assumptions, basically, you do like this. So what does it tells you? What is assumptions, beam theory? So this means the centroidal axis, you followed. In beam theory, what is that you try to say? Centroidal axis is same as, what is that? You use one more term, you know, for that axis.
Neutral axis.
Neutral axis actually. So centroidal axis is same as neutral axis. So these assumption you followed, right? So these are how it comes. Centroidal axis is same as neutral axis. That means sigma z dA should be zero kind of a thing. Then when you take for movement, you know, you can derive like this. Okay. So it's not a big deal. You followed, right? So you can derive all the terms, you know, in our strength of material theory. This is how we try to do it in our Euler-Bernoulli beam theory. So the most important thing here, what we try to do is, you know, so because this is possible, we have neglected the shear. The reason is, you know, because of this theta, okay? So which is same as du by dz, and it is same as, you see, dw by dx itself. That is how we try to do. So here the assumption is the plane cross sections, they remain perpendicular after deformation also, you follow, right, to the centroidal axis. So this is how, you know, we write actually. Z into theta, so where theta is, you know, your dw by dx, okay? So this is how we write. Of course, in UG, you know, the notation may be like this, I think, dy by dx or something, you know, we try to write in our undergraduate, okay? So now the same concept we have to do for plate theory also. So for plate also, the assumption is, you know, the plane cross sections remain plane, and the most important thing is they remain always perpendicular to your centroidal surfaces, okay? That is the only thing. So now we have to find out expressions for u bar, v bar, w bar, okay? So now at this centroid for a beam, say, Euler-Bernoulli beam, at the neutral axis, u is zero, okay? But whereas u bar, say, at any point, say, on our plane cross section, at this place, u is given by this z into theta, which is, you know, z into dw by dx actually. So same concept, we use it here in our plate theory also. So now let us write the expressions for, you see, u bar, v bar, z bar using the same concept, okay? So whatever, you know, we used in our beam theory. So now your u bar, say. So now your u bar, okay? So here also, you know, the plate is bending only in the z direction, okay? The transverse load is here. So using the same concept to say, so u is equal to, u is for the centroidal axis, minus z dou w by dou x, okay? So same as beam theory. So now V bar say, this is also same V, Z into, you know, so dou W by dou Y, and W bar say, at any plane cross section is same as W itself, okay? So this comes from, as already I told you, Euler-Bernoulli beam theory. So the same as U is equal to Z times theta here, and because there are two angles are there, say, okay? So you will have, you know, these things. So this is a concept here. No, u is equal to z cross theta, okay? So which is same as y. The reason is, you know, plane cross sections remain perpendicular, so this distance will be, you know, r cross theta kind of a thing we use. So these are the displacement. Suppose if at the centroid, say, u and v are zero, say, then obviously you can delete these two terms itself, okay? So these how we write. So these are the displacements at any plane cross section. So these things will give you displacements at any point, say, at any, you know, at any point in the plane cross section. Okay, so you please remember, so what we have done is exactly same as Euler-Bernoulli only. Only thing here is, you know, we are doing it in a two-dimensional fashion itself. Okay, so now this is the displacements, how they are linked. So now let us write strains. Okay. So now, so the strains, say, so epsilon, you know, x bar, okay? So you are, you know, right, the expression for strains, okay? So dou u bar by, you see, dou x, plus, so now here also, generally we write epsilon xx as dou u by dou x, okay? Suppose if you include this Lagrangian strain, say, okay? So if I use Lagrangian strain, which means I'm including even the higher order terms also, okay? So I have terms like, you know, so dou w bar by dou x whole square. So I have terms, you know, this you followed. So dou u bar by dou x, all those higher order terms also will come into picture. But now in the plate problem, say, only w is going to be very large actually, okay? This out of plane deformation. So these things we neglect, okay? The higher order terms in u bar and v bar we neglect here. So you will be having, you know, so these terms only, you know, we will include in our calculations, okay? The large strains, we are, what we are saying, yes, okay? So we use this Lagrangian strain itself. So including the higher order terms. So if I write the strain displacements, so similarly epsilon y bar, okay? So dou v bar by, you know, dou y plus half. Okay, so dou w bar, you know, by dou y whole square. So we are including the higher order terms also. Now similarly, gamma xy also will come. So this will be, you know, dou u bar by, you know, dou y plus dou v bar by, you see, dou x. So plus you have, you know, dou w bar by, you know, dou x, and then dou w bar say by dou y. Okay, so we have included, you see, the higher order terms in our strains. So if you include these higher order terms, generally, you know, people call this as, you know, von Kármán plate theory. Now you followed. So there are some different names have been given. Okay, so if you neglect these higher order terms, say, so, you know, so this higher order terms, whatever we are having, okay, if you include them, we call that as von Kármán. If you don't include these terms, say, so then we generally people call as, you know, linear, you know, the strains theory, something, you see, some names are there even in plates also. Okay, so these how we see, we write, you can include or you cannot include. We will see what is the effect of including these things. The reason why these things are required is, you know, for plates, say, generally, see, generally in beams, once a beam has buckled, okay, or any structures, arch or whatever, anything, if it has buckled, means, you know, it becomes useless, okay, so it is of no use, you know, it cannot take any more load once it has buckled, okay. But plates, there is a specialty, we will see after some time. So what happens in plates is, once the plate is buckled, say, still it can carry, you know, the load actual, okay, the post buckling strength, we say. So for plates, what happens is, once it has buckled, you know, it is not useless, okay. After buckling also, it still can carry, you know, extra load, you know, this plate. That is a speciality about these plates. Why it is, anyway, we will see after some point of a time. So post buckling strength also becomes very important. See, like for example, these columns and beams and other things, say, once they have buckled, you know, that's it actually, okay. So they cannot take any load, okay. So they are useless, you followed it. They cannot take any load, but plates, you know, this is entirely a different thing. We will see after some point of a time. So that's why, you know, because when you try to estimate this post buckling strength of plates and others, these higher order terms becomes very, very important. That's why, you know, this von Kármán plate theory, say, is very, you know, you followed it. People use it in analysis and design of these plates, because to estimate this post buckling strength of this plates itself. Suppose if you are pre-buckling, say, so we are not interested in the post buckling, before itself, if you want to estimate, then maybe these higher order terms, say, maybe, you know, you can neglect, and you know, you can get some you know, a very good you know, estimates about the distinct. But after, when you want to calculate post buckling strength, then, you know, so already, because the plate is buckled, right, so it has already deformations there, so the higher order terms becomes very, very important. That's why we include these higher order terms in our calculations, okay. But these things are very important for this kind of post buckling strengths, okay, not for this one. So that's why, you know, this is a very, very popular kind of a thing. So now here, right, so this, that's why, you know, these higher order terms comes, the Lagrangian, you know, the strain is used in the calculations. So now you substitute, okay, so you substitute u bar, so now you substitute, you know, this u bar v bar, u bar v bar, say, in above equations, okay, that is these equations we have already written u bar as, you know, these expressions, okay. So this, if you substitute, say, in our these three strain equations, so we can write as you know, so epsilon x bar. So this you can write as epsilon x minus z into dou square w by dou x square, which you can also write this as epsilon x plus z into some kappa factor, okay, this one. Now similarly, it's epsilon y bar. So this is epsilon y minus z into dou square w by dou x y square. So we can write this expression as epsilon x plus z into some ky. Okay, now in a similar fashion, say, gamma bar, okay, xy. So this also can be written as gamma xy minus 2 times z dou square w by dou x into dou y, so which is same as gamma xy plus 2 times z k x y, where our this epsilon x is a. So this is dou u by dou x. This we have written in terms of centroidal axis. Okay, half into dou w by dou x whole square. Then your epsilon y. So this is dou v by dou y plus half so dou w say by dou y whole square. Then our gamma x y. So this becomes so dou u by dou y plus dou v by dou u by dou x plus we have dou w by dou x and then dou w by dou y. Okay, so these are the strains in terms of centroidal coordinates. This gamma bar, epsilon bar, so these are the strains at any point in our plane cross section. Okay, and kx, ky, these are nothing but the curvatures, we can call this as. So kx, ky, you can also write that expression. So kx is say minus dou square w by dou x square, and similarly ky minus dou square w by dou y square, and then kxy dou square w by dou x into dou y. So these are the final the terms whatever we have. Okay, the strain displacement relationships. Okay, so now we have written equation of equilibrium, then strain displacements are there. Now the next thing, what is another thing which is missing? What is that we have to do now? What is one more equation we have to do? What is the one thing which is missing? See, equations of equilibrium we have written in terms of stress resultant. Strain displacements are there. Now, what is the next thing you have to write?
Stress strain.
Stress strain relation. Yes. Okay. So, since this is anyway a plane stress, so you followed, right? So, you can write, you already know, right? In your advanced structural mechanics, you have already studied these equations itself. So already I will not go into the details. So if you want, you can go through this L.S. Srinath or any textbook, okay, for the stress strain relations. So for plane stress, already 1 minus mu square epsilon x bar plus mu epsilon y bar, then we have sigma y bar set. E by 1 minus mu square, so epsilon y bar plus mu into epsilon x bar, then we have tau x y. So this is E by 2 into 1 plus mu, so gamma bar x y. So these are the stress strains. So now you substitute, whatever stress strain relations are there. So now so you substitute, So you substitute or maybe you followed, right? Your substitute, or you can write the stress strain relations in terms of stress resultants also, above equations. Now in stress resultants. Or what we are trying to do is, instead of writing in terms of the stress strain relations, we want to write a stress resultant strain relations. Okay, this is what we are trying to do. You already know, right, what is the relationship between nx, ny. I think last class we already wrote these equations. What I mean to say is, so what we mean to say is, these equations. So you can see, right? So these are the stress resultant equations. Okay. So you substitute sigma x, sigma yy, sigma this thing, and then you integrate with respect to h. Okay. So if you do that one anyway, it's very straightforward, because things are not varying with respect to the z direction. One can easily write these expressions like this. So finally, the stress resultant strain relations, you can substitute and you can write nx as some constant c multiplied by epsilon x plus mu epsilon y after so much of algebra, so and n y. Epsilon y plus mu epsilon x, then n x y. C into 1 minus mu gamma x y by 2. Then we have bending moments also. Minus d dou square w by, you know, dou x square plus mu dou y square. Then we have m y. For dou square w by dou y square plus mu dou square w by dou x square. So these are the moments, and mxy also we can write. 1 minus mu. So dou square w by, you know, dou x into dou y. Okay. So where your terms say, so c, so which is eh by, you know, 1 minus mu square, and d. So this is eh cube by, you see, 12 into, you know, 1 minus mu square. Okay, so these are so now these things we have, see, like now what is you know, so now you can see d really links m with curvature, bending moments with the curvature, whereas this constant c, say, it relates, you know, the axial forces or the axial stress resultants with axial strains, kind of a thing. Okay, so sometimes, so the c and d, say, so this generally it is known as an axial rigidity. You followed, whereas D, so this is known as the bending rigidity. Okay, because that is the link, you know, this bending moment and curvature. Other one is, you know, the axial forces and then, you see, these things itself. So these are our stress resultant, strain, sorry, displacement relations. Okay, stress strain. So from stress strain, we have gone to stress resultant strains, and then you substitute epsilon x, epsilon y, all those things. So finally, you know, you get this thing. So now you substitute, say, these equations. Okay. So you substitute stress resultant tent displacement relations. Now, in our equation of equilibrium, okay. So finally, if you substitute, you know, all those complex things, say, okay. So this thing, so finally what happens is, you know, the last equation, so that is sigma fz is equal to zero, that equation was, you know, writing in terms of bending moments and axial stresses. So finally, you know, you can write this expression as, you know, so like this, so d, okay, so dou to the power of w by dou x to the power of 4 plus 2 times dou y square plus dou to the power of 4 w by dou y to the power of 4, okay, is equal to, on the right hand side, so this becomes nx dou square w by, you know, dou x square plus n y dou y square plus 2 times, you know, nx y dou x dou y. Of course, you have the load, which is, so you can get, so this is our equation, you see, finally comes into picture, and we have anyway the extra equations are there, so dou nx by dou x plus dou n yx, say, by dou y, so this is equal to 0, and other equation is, you know, so dou nxy, so automatically this gets satisfied by dou x plus dou ny by, you see, dou y is equal to 0. So this is what we call as the fundamental, you know, the von Kármán, you know, the plate equation actually. Okay, so von Kármán plate equations we call, so this set of three equations. So von Kármán, you know, the plate equations. So what do you mean by Kirchhoff assumptions? So generally these things you should know. So like generally in a plate theory, say, if somebody says what is meant by Kirchhoff plate condition, so Kirchhoff means same as your Euler-Bernoulli. Plane sections remain plane, plane sections remain perpendicular. Then if von Kármán, say, von Kármán means, you know, you have included even the higher order terms in our strains itself. Okay. So if we include, you know, finally, you see, we'll get expressions like this. Now, how do you know that this equation is correct? Okay. How do you verify this one? Oh, sorry.
If we remove higher order terms, sir, it should go to Kirchhoff.
No. This fundamental equation. See, you have having this equation, right? Okay. See this equation. Okay. So now here you followed, right? If we come to this, if we assume it to be a beam actually. Now what happens? See, like your Euler-Bernoulli beam theory, you remember. So if there is a concentrated load or whatever, this type of a beam theory is there. So if you neglect, one dimension, say. So what happens if you neglect this, this in-plane forces also. Axial forces also. Now what happens to these expressions? So if you ignore all the terms, say. So what happens? So this term, then this term, then these terms, all of them will go to zero. So finally you get, you see, so d to the power of 4 w by dx to the power of 4 is equal to p itself. You remember. So now in strength of material theory also, what is our equation of motion? See, d, remember, d square y by dx to the power of 4, the fourth order derivative, say. It is nothing but q itself. So here also it is same thing only, okay? So here also, if you want to verify, if you neglect other thing, it should come back to your, whatever you studied previously itself. Of course, there it becomes a Q by EI actually, you remember. See, on the right hand side, you have EI actually, okay? But now, since it is a plate, say, so you have this D. So your flexural rigidity has been replaced with D. D is also like your bending rigidity. So you can check whether, whether your equation is correct or not. So if you collapse one dimension, it has to come back to your original, Euler-Bernoulli, whatever equation you have, okay? So these way, we can verify this equations itself. So I will stop here. So next class, we will start our buckling actually. So since we have already derived this plate equations, okay? So what I suggest to all of you is, whatever derivation I have done, say, it is available in this textbook itself. You please rederive all these equations, okay? Because, maybe I would have skipped some steps in the derivation, so you please read it, and then I think it will be fine. Okay, so we go back to our meeting. So if you have anything to ask, you can ask.